Welcome. My name is Jake Steiner. I used to have minus 5 diopter, high myopia. I was wearing really thick glasses. Currently talking, I don't need glasses anymore. I haven't had LASIK. I don't wear contact lenses. I don't do eye exercises. I don't put weird crap in my eyes like this dude is doing. And yet I recovered all of my sight. There is a ton of nonsense online and specifically on YouTube that people love to watch, and it gets millions of views, sadly. Here's me making kind of an attempt at looking at some of this stuff and explaining why it doesn't work. I'm not doing an amazing job because I'm not a super professional, but today we're looking at this Ayurvedic solution that people propose. And we're going to follow this along for a little bit of a moment. Feel free to try it. In my own journey, when I started improving my eyesight over 20 years ago, I tried all this stuff also. I lived in Nepal for a while. I did eye yoga. I did eye acupuncture there specifically, a Red Bates method. I tried all this stuff, eventually came up with a little bit of a more science and biology specific solution. You can check out nmyopia.org in the links below. We've got hundreds of thousands of people that have done this over the last 20 years and had great success. That is not to crap on other methods. I'm saying try them, but I'm saying use a little bit of critical thinking while you're doing these things and while you're exploring stuff. Here's a dude's video.
This is one of the most requested videos on this channel, but can we really get rid of spectacles? Well, to get answer, I did examine many of our ancient classical texts and have also had conversations with multiple top-notch modern medical doctors.
Wait. Ancient texts. So whenever you're looking for solutions to health issues, to biology issues, why are you looking at ancient texts? Wouldn't you look at the most latest modern insights into how biology works? What did people know 100, 500, 1,000 years ago about eye biology? Not a whole lot, right? Anyway.
Understand both the perspectives. While modern medical experts offer no solution other than surgery, on the other hand...
That's true.
Ayurveda has a set of simple practices through which thousands of people have already recovered their lost vision.
Who? Okay, fine. If you say so. Okay.
To this day, modern doctors won't be able to digest this fact, but Ayurveda clearly states that irrespective of what your age is...
Okay, so this is the problem, right? Like, we're being let down by modern retail medicine, not offering us answers, so people are stuck wading through this mud. Why this is mud?
All you need are a few natural ingredients, conviction in your mind, and a strong determination to get rid of the crutches forever. And that's what this video is all about. So get your first checkup done today, and let's get started with the video. Hello friends, welcome to Fittuber. Early in the morning after waking up, I believe that majority of us do splash some water on eyes. However, while treating serious medical conditions like lost vision, it is important that you take your eyewash routine to the next level. To accomplish that, first fill your mouth full with water. This expands the eye muscles properly.
What? Okay. Now, this dude has like 5 million subscribers and this video has got millions of views. And this is what's sad, right? Like you and the ancient texts. How does filling your mouth with water expand eye muscles? Which eye muscles? How would that happen? Are they not in a separate space in your skull? Oh, God.
Now splash cold water on the eyes a few times. This will give an instant cooling effect to the eyes. You can feel it. But wait, it's not over yet. Once your eyes are wide awake and cool, a rose water wash is the next thing to do.
A rose water wash. Now, what do you want to bet that he explains exactly what rose water does to the lipid layer, the surface of liquid that's on top of your eyes that he's going to displace with this stuff? How that's better than what your body produces to protect your eye. Ready?
You need to buy one eyewash cup, easily available in optical and Ayurvedic shops. I have even linked it in the description box for you to buy it online. Put about 15 drops of pure gulab jal along with cold water in it. Now place it on any one eye first. ensure that the water does not spill out from the sides. Open your eye and let the gulab jal mixed water touch the eye surface. Move your pupil in all directions so that the water gets circulated properly inside the eye. Spend about 1 minute doing this. Now throw this water away and refill the cup in the same way with fresh water and...
Okay, you're not going to watch this whole entire thing. What? He's not explaining the point. He's not going to explain a point. There is no point. Fine. Next one.
Causes of weak eyesight. Moving on to step number 2. Alright then, after eyewash, the next step is to drink this powerful homemade tonic that will directly nourish the nerves of the eyes, helping restore lost vision. Take 7 soaked and peeled arms.
Science. Please quote some science, some study, something about how soaked and peeled 7 almonds nourished the nerves of your eye.
Almonds. Not the regular California almonds, but Gurbandi almonds. Gurbandi almonds are small-sized almonds native of Indian subcontinent, which are way more richer in oil, vitamin A, E, and other nutrients helpful for the eyes. Along with this, you will need 4 seeds of whole black pepper. Sweeten it with a bit of thread mishri. Put all the 3 in a mortar and using a pestle, crush them together.
Okay, so this is super common, I think, in various circles. Some that I enjoy on a personal level sometimes, where people love complicated sounding, super specific routines that are not grounded in any sort of science or reality or connection to issues or lacking stuff. You can take a blood panel, right? Like you can check vitamins, you can check minerals, you can check any kind of deficiencies your body may have that affect your eyes as much as the rest of your body. Eyes are not separate from your body. Yes, they need specific things more than other parts of your body, but it's one system. So first step to knowing whether you need to crush up 7 almonds is there some kind of almond-related deficiency? What's in almonds specifically that your body needs? Do a blood panel. And I'm not saying that's the entire truth, right? Like certainly there's plenty of room for other stuff. I tell you though, I will put whatever you want. You tell me, you email me a bit. That you have several doctors of myopia, you go to the optometrist to confirm it, you do all this crap for however long you want to, or the dude says, and then show me the results after. Your eyesight's gonna be the freaking same.
To form a smooth paste. Now take a pan on low flame and put 1 glass of milk in it. Add the paste in it. Now let the milk boil for 10 minutes on low flame.
Okay, let's not do any of that.
Alright then, 30 minutes before going to sleep at night, you have to take a mixture of 1 teaspoon of Mahatrifla Ghrit along with 250 milligrams of Abrak Basam. Follow this up with 1 glass of warm milk. Mahatrifla Ghrit is a combination of ghee along with over a dozen herbs that calm the heat and dryness of the eyes.
No, it doesn't. Okay, so if you're new, and I'm sorry I made you watch all this, if you did, cause of myopia. It's a focusing muscle spasm. Go to scholar.google.com, type in pseudomyopia. There are studies going back 50 years that explain the cause of your nearsightedness or shortsightedness, and it starts out as a focusing muscle spasm. There's a muscle in your eye that moves the lens for close-up focus when you're looking at something up close. That muscle, called the ciliary, is super tight to bulge the lens out to focus light on the back of your retina, on the back of your eye, on your retina. You do that too much, that muscle spasms. That's your nearsightedness, and that becomes lens-induced myopia once you start wearing glasses. Whatever you're eating has absolutely no impact. You can be freaking Arnold Schwarzenegger and still need glasses. You can be obese and still not need glasses. Like, it is not. There's no deficiency in nutrients that is causing your eyesight to be bad, and there's no magical thing you can eat to make your eyesight better. It starts with you're staring at screens too much and you're not spending enough time outside, and then it continues when you have that muscle spasm going to the optometrist, who is then selling you really expensive glasses.
Some, on the other hand, is prepared from mica and several other indigenous herbs. Both Mahatrifla Ghrit and Abrak Basam are classical Ayurvedic medicines, highly effective in treating eye disorders. Coming to step number 4,
Wait! What eye disorders? Okay, so myopia is not an eye disorder, right? It's a muscle spasm. And then later when it becomes lens-induced because you wear glasses, the eye elongates. The eye is perfectly healthy. There's no disorder.
Before sleeping, take a few drops of Mahatrifla Ghrit on your hands and massage the soles of your feet.
Ah!
The nerve... beneath the soles are directly connected to the optic nerves.
How are the bottom of your feet directly connected to your optic nerves? Somebody pick me up a biology book and tell me how that's the case.
This instantly increases blood circulation, which helps improve vision. Finally, the last step is to put a couple of drops of the same Mahatrifala Ghrit in each of your eyes. Wait for about 10 minutes before you open them. The eyes will go blurry for a while, and that's when you know that ghee has seeped well into the eyes.
Whenever your eyes are blurry, that's not a good sign. You put crap in your eyes and you can't see right after that. That is not a good thing. Better rub stuff on your feet. At least you're not screwing up your eyes.
The glory of Mahatrifala Ghrit has been sung at length in the ancient texts.
You're selling it.
Mahatrifala Ghrit is a day works, whether it is for Navi, and I'll share it in my stories. I have handpicked all the products used in this routine.
Here we go.
I've linked them down in the description box for you to buy. I want to thank Oziva for partnering with us for this video. Check out Oziva's plant-based biotin and their amazing protein and herbs made separately for men and women. Oziva's biotin is a whole food derived from plants to reduce hair fall.
All right, so what did we learn here? We learned that all the things the guy recommends, he doesn't include any kind of science, any kind of studies, any kind of biology references, any kind of causality being addressed. If you stick rose water in your eye, were your eyes missing rose water? Is that why you're seeing poorly? Does everybody who's got perfect eyesight live near roses by accident? What is the rose water doing? All he does, and all these people do in general, is suggest random steps to you that sound complicated, and you have to use this bean and not that bean, and you have to use five and not six of them to make you think there's something behind this. What should make you think there's something behind this is somebody saying, hey, here's how we understand that the biology works. Look up some studies. Here's a bunch of people who've tried this, and here's how it worked for them. Again, myopia.org, link below. I'm not saying our thing is a truth. I'm saying critical thinking and looking at who specifically has this worked for and why before you put too much hope into these methods. That's all for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you want more of these, because this was the first kind of attempt vaguely at one of these, let me know in the comments below, and see you in the next one. Meow, 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 meow.